Hello and welcome to CBT Nuggets Exam Pack 7630, Microsoft Office SharePoint Server 2007 Configuring. My name is Tim Werner, and I'm happy and grateful to be your instructor. My goal in developing this course for you is twofold. Number one, I want to improve your practical skills with SharePoint servers. You may be forced by circumstance of a new job or a new initiative at your current job to deploy MOS 2007, and you're like a lot of folks are, okay, now what do I do? There's a lot to MOS, where do I start? So I'm hoping by the time you finish this CBT Nugget series, you'll have a lot of good practical and theoretical skills under your belt. The other goal in my designing this course is to help you pass the 7630 SharePoint 2007 configuration exam. Passing that exam will qualify you as a Microsoft Certified Technology Specialist, or MCTS. I've structured the course linearly and sequentially. That's what these three arrows are showing up here, that I've listed the 20 nuggets that comprise this product in such a way that you'll get maximum benefit from them if you do follow them sequentially. We're going to be building skills that we refer to later. So if you just hop into the middle of the Nugget series, you might find me just mention concepts and things we've done before that if you haven't watched those earlier Nuggets might cause a little bit of confusion. So I want to give you that heads up. Why don't we step through these 20 Nuggets to get an idea of what to expect. First, we're going to introduce the product. We're going to take care of some common misconceptions and confusions regarding SharePoint Server and its relationship to SharePoint Services. Planning is critical for any deployment of MOS, so we'll devote an entire nugget to planning and architectural issues. Installing MOS, again, if you're not planning correctly and you don't know the ramifications of making each choice during installation, you can really get hosed by the end of the day. Once we have MOS installed on our server, we'll begin to build out sites, and that's broken over two nuggets, as you see. There's quite a bit to that, because that's a core skill of the SharePoint administrator. To that end as well, we need to address MOS 2000 security, the principle of least privilege, least service, etc. We'll devote two nuggets to administering MOS 2007 sites. The 7630 exam assumes that you know quite a bit about, for instance, the STS-ADM command line tool. We're going to introduce that tool throughout this whole series, and I hope that you'll be very comfortable with it by the time you're done. Lists and libraries form the core of your information store in a SharePoint deployment. We need to understand how those work. And actually, this is foundational because we're going to be doing a lot more with lists and libraries through the rest of the course. For instance, we've got wikis, blogs, and workspaces, collaboration features, content policies. All that stuff supports what's called enterprise content management and web content management. More will be revealed on that as we go along, friends. Content types make your lives as SharePoint administrators much easier and improves user experience in those document libraries and lists. Workflow, again, is an automation technology that's really hot with the .NET Framework 3.0. It's called Windows Workflow Foundation, or WF, and you'll learn exactly how it works in that nugget. We'll concentrate on business intelligence. This deals with stuff like business intelligence dashboards, Excel web access, and so on. Another enterprise feature that's critical to understanding and maximizing your bang for the buck with MOS is InfoPath Form Services. Here we can deploy InfoPath forms in a browser to save licensing fees and, again, to make it as easy as possible to convert to a paperless office. Administering search and indexing will show you how to enhance and accentuate and maximize your user's search experience. After all, over time, your MOS portal is going to grow pretty large, I would imagine. We want to make it easy for our users to find the documents, list items, and people that they need in the course of a workday. Toward the tail end of the course, we'll be doing backup and restore, upgrading from SharePoint Portal Server 2003 to MOS 2007, and then we'll finish with a flourish by looking at how to monitor and performance tune MOS 2007. So there you have it, friends. I hope you're psyched. I certainly am. We're going to have a lot of fun, and you're going to enhance your skills and hopefully pass that dadgum exam in no time flat. So let's get started.